Hi there, welcome back. I'm Leo and today I'm going to be talking about some useful idiomatic expressions with parts of the body. Olá, bem-vindos de volta. Eu sou o Leo e hoje eu falarei sobre algumas expressões idiomáticas com partes do corpo. Stick around. Expressões idiomáticas, assim como no português, são usadas o tempo todo no inglês do dia a dia. E aprender como e quando usá-las é uma questão de sobrevivência no mundo real do inglês. Nesse vídeo eu trago 15 delas, hoje com expressões sobre partes do corpo. Sem mais delongas, let's jump right in. It costs an arm and a leg. If something costs an arm and a leg, it's very expensive. Em português usamos uma expressão com partes do corpo também. Custa os olhos da cara.
And it won't cost you an arm and a leg.
Probably cost an arm and a leg. Then
it's because you knew it cost me a fucking arm and a leg.
You're charging us an arm and a leg for something
which costs us an arm and a leg to rent and no.
It's on the tip of my tongue. You know the word, but you just cannot remember it at the particular moment. Esta é bem igual à nossa expressão, né? Está na ponta da língua.
It's on the tip of my tongue.
It's on the tip of my tongue. It starts with a T.
Sure we do. It's on the tip of my tongue.
It's on the tip of my tongue.
Stick one's neck out. Personally assume or expose oneself to some risk, danger or responsibility. Também temos partes do corpo nas nossas expressões para esse significado, né? Pôr a mão no fogo por alguém ou por algo, arriscar o pescoço, entrar de peito aberto ou de cabeça.
Really stick his neck out like that.
And I am not going to stick my neck out.
I didn't stick my neck out. It was an accident.
Here, I stick my neck out for you.
Get off one's chest. Review or discuss something that has caused one emotional discomfort. Desabafar, abrir o coração, se abrir.
Okay, get it off your chest.
Get off your chest, Mr. Gamby.
Doesn't it feel good to get that off your chest?
That's a lot to get off your chest.
Get it off your chest. Go on.
Keep your chin up. Remain cheerful in difficult circumstances. Também temos partes do corpo na expressão. Mantenha a cabeça erguida, levante a cabeça. Te anima.
Just keep your chin up.
Keep your chin up.
Thank you.
You keep your chin up, kid.
Anyway, keep your chin up, you keep blood.
Come on, keep your chin up.
I'm all ears. You are very interested and ready to listen to what another person wants to tell you. Essa é bem literal, né? Sou todo ouvidos.
I'm all ears.
I'm all ears.
I'm all ears.
Self.
I'm all ears.
I'm all ears.
The cold shoulder. Be unfriendly to somebody by intentionally ignoring them. Tratar com frieza, dar um gelo em alguém. Tratar com indiferença. Ignorar.
And now you give me the cold shoulder.
Really giving me the cold shoulder.
His wife was giving him the cold shoulder.
Get this through your head. You can give me the cold shoulder the rest of your life.
The upper hand. The position of having power or being in control in a particular situation. Estar por cima, ter a vantagem, ser superior, ter o controle.
In this situation.
I always have the upper hand.
Now I have the upper hand, and I...
Now that I have the upper hand, let's get started.
Once in my life, I would like the upper hand. I have no hand, no hand at all.
But it looks like I have the upper hand now.
Sweet tooth. A desire for tasty treats like candy, chocolate, or other sweet things. Sabe quando você expressa sua preferência por doces? Eu sou dos doces, mais de gulodices.
Mr. Sweet Tooth.
Dessert, then. I got a sweet tooth.
I know that I have a sweet tooth.
Daddy's got a sweet tooth tonight! Eye-catching. Attractive or unusual, and therefore noticed. Atrativo, atraente, apelativo, cativante.
Her eye-catching presentations.
How incredibly eye-catching you yourself are.
And the first step is an eye-catching resume.
It's modern, it's witty, it's eye-catching.
It's like pulling teeth. Very difficult, especially to extract information from someone. É como arrancar dente. Bem difícil, né? É uma tortura, quase impossível.
It was like pulling teeth.
Thanks. It was like pulling teeth.
So conversations are like pulling teeth.
It's like pulling teeth, you know? Finally, it's like pulling teeth.
Keep ones at an arm's length. Avoid being very close to or friendly with someone or something. Claro que a expressão significando um braço só de distância parece que é para manter por perto, né? Mas é o contrário, é para manter bem longe e evitar contato.
The king will always keep her at arm's length.
Robert had managed until now to keep Patrice at arm's length.
That's why I've been keeping you at arm's length.
I need to keep her at arm's length this weekend.
I was okay when you kept me in an arm's length because...
Born with a silver spoon in the mouth. It means that you are born into a rich family. Seria o nosso, nasceu em berço de ouro, ou seja, não sabe o que é dificuldade, nunca passou dificuldade na vida.
The poor with a silver spoon in your mouth.
I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth, Miss Hawkins.
You know I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth.
World, but I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth.
I know you probably think I was born with a silver spoon in my mouth.
Get cold feet. Become too frightened and nervous to do something you had planned to do. Ficar com medo, dar para trás, desistir-se, acovardar.
Getting cold feet, Albie?
You're not getting cold feet, are you, Jeffrey?
Are you getting cold feet?
You're getting cold feet.
Why are you getting cold feet?
More than meets the eye. It's more difficult to understand or involves more things than you thought at the beginning. Aí tem coisa. É melhor ficar com o pé atrás. Isso é só a ponta do iceberg. Isso é mais do que aparenta ser.
I believe there's more than meets the eye.
There's more than meets the eye.
There is more here than meets the eye.
There's much more to us than meets the eye.
There's actually more there than meets the eye.
Ok, guys, that's all for today. Me deixem saber se gostaram com aquele like de sempre. Se você ainda não é inscrito, me dê essa chance. Assim você não perderá nada, porque o YouTube avisará você assim que tiver um vídeo novo. Vejo vocês no próximo vídeo. I'll see you next time. Stay safe.